Hello everyone, my name is Ms. Rashmi Chhetri. Today we are going to do GK, it's Knowledge Quest 3 for class 3. But before that, I welcome all the students of class 3 over here. So, today we will do chapter number 4, 5 and 6, okay? So everyone, take out your book. The name of the book is Knowledge Quest 3, okay, for class 3. So move on to page number 8, the chapter number 4, the name of the chapter, it's wildlife, okay. So here there are different type of pictures given, like different type of animals, all the wild creatures, okay. The pictures are given, so we have to identify each picture and we have to name them. So for that, everyone, just go through your book, look at your book and let's do it one by one, okay? So the first picture shows like a duck, but is it duck? No, let's see, okay? This bird has the largest wingspan. This bird has the largest wingspan. And which bird is that? It's wandering albatross. Everyone, say with me, wandering albatross. But I hope that you all have took out your notebooks, pencils, everything, and this one you can write down in your book also, okay? So speak and write, say and write. The first one is this bird has the largest wingspan. It's wandering albatross, w-a-n-d-e-r-i-n-g, wandering albatross. The second one, this strange sea creature looks like a horse. See, in the picture it's yellow in color and the image is like horse. It looks like a horse, but it is not a horse, it is a sea creature, okay? And so the name is seahorse. It is said as seahorse, it looks like a horse, right? But it lives in sea, that's why it is called seahorse. S-E-A-H-O-R-S-E, seahorse. Let's move on to the third one. This bird is often seen near coast, means in near the river, like bank of the river. It is seen near sea coast. So what is this? It is pelagic birds, okay? P-E-L-A-G-I-C, pelagic and birds, pelagic birds, okay? So the fourth one is, it is the most intelligent sea creature. Dolphin, okay? And dolphin, you know about dolphin, right? It looks so nice also, and it has different, dolphin has different type of qualities, like it can jump high over, if it is trained then it can jump high over, different type of, like it is for entertainment also. Somewhere you can see dolphin is used to entertain, okay, in the other countries or in this way, or you might have seen in the TV also about dolphin. So the dolphin is the most intelligent sea creatures. Number fifth, this bird has large bills to hold fish. What is it? It is pelicans, okay? P-E-L-I-C-A-N-S. Next one, number six. It is the national bird of New Zealand. It cannot fly. This bird is the national bird of New Zealand, but it is flightless. That means it cannot fly. And the name is kiwis. K-I-W-I-S. Okay? Students, tell me, what is the national bird of our country, that is India? Yes, peacock. Very good. So the kiwis is the national bird of New Zealand and it cannot fly also. That means it is flightless. Number seven, it is the largest bear. It lives near the Arctic Ocean, okay? It is the largest bear and it lives near the Arctic Ocean. So what is this? It is polar bear, okay? P-O-L-A-R, polar, B-E-A-R, bear, okay? So number eight, an Australian animal that lives on trees. The picture it shows here, the animal, it is an Australian animal and it lives on trees. It is tree kangaroos, okay? TREE tree, KANGAROS, tree kangaroos, okay? So this is an Australian animal and it lives on trees. Number 9, it looks like a dog. It looks like a dog but has skull and teeth of a cat, okay? The image is like it looks like a dog but it has a skull and teeth of a like a cat. And what is it? It is wolf, W-O-L-F, wolf, okay? So everyone pause the video and copy down in your book. Now let's move on to chapter number 5, flightless bird. Just now I told you what is flightless, the birds that cannot fly. It's too shocking, na? Like the bird can fly, but here it's written flightless bird. That means the birds, that means there are some birds that cannot fly. Okay, so what are they? Let's see. Everyone look at the book and read with me. First one is ostrich, okay? O-S-T-R-I-C-H, ostrich. Second one is rhea, R-H-E-A. And the third one is emu, E-M-U. And the last one is cassowary, okay? So let's read it in details one by one. The ostrich is the biggest living bird and it is about 2.5 meters tall. See, the ostrich is the biggest living bird and it is about 2.5 meters tall. It's so big that its egg weighs about 1.5 kg. Okay, it is so big that its egg weighs about 1.5 kg. It is found in Africa. Where it is found? It is found in Africa. An ostrich cannot fly but can run about 65 kilometers an hour. Can you imagine? 65 kilometers per hour it can run. Means it cannot fly but it can run. The male ostrich is black in color with white plumes. And the female is brown in color. Second one, the rhea is also a flightless bird and is about 1.2 meters tall. It is like the ostrich but smaller in size. It looks like it is like an ostrich but it is smaller in size. It has 3 toes while the ostrich has 2. Okay, it has 3 toes and ostrich has 2 toes. Okay, it lays up to 50 eggs at a time. At a single time, it lays 50 eggs and is native to South America. Okay. Next one, the emu is another flightless bird and is the second largest living bird. Okay, remember all these things, that the emu, it is the largest flightless bird, another flightless bird, and is the second largest living bird. Like the rhea, it has 3 toes. It lays about 7 to 10 dark green eggs. 7 to 10 dark green eggs it can lay. Each egg is around 13 centimeter long and weight about 250 gram each. We find them in Australia, okay? We find ostrich in Africa and this bird in Australia, okay? Next one, the cassowary is a large flightless bird found in the tropical forest of New Guinea and northeastern Australia. It is smaller only to ostrich and emu. It lays about 3 to 8 eggs and it feeds mainly on fruits and seeds, although at times can feed on small insects. So these were the names of some flightless bird, okay? You can read it thoroughly by yourself also. So now let's do this second chapter. The last chapter is chapter number 6, Animal World. Okay, let's see what it's there written there. How much do you know about the animals we see around us? Take the correct choice. Okay, which of the following is not a carnivorous? Among this, which is the animal that is not carnivorous? Carnivorous hunts for flesh. Before solving this, remember this thing, that carnivorous hunts for flesh, okay? And herbivorous is all the animal that eats plants. Okay, and the question here is, among this, which is the following of not a carnivorous? Tiger, it eats flesh. Snake also, it eats flesh. Dog also, and the rest, last one, rhinoceros is the answer. Okay, rhinoceros is a herbivorous. It doesn't comes under carnivorous. Okay, rhinoceros eats plants. So the answer will be rhinoceros. Second one, which one has the shortest lifespan? The answer is butterfly. Okay, all other birds have a little bit long lifespan, but butterfly have only a few lifespan. Okay, I think only near about 24 hours. Okay, number third, which one has the longest life, average lifespan? It's humans. Okay, humans can live about 100 years also. Okay, but not animals. The number four, the animal that cannot see at night, very easy, it's owl. Number fifth, the bird that acted as a messenger in the past, pigeon was the bird. Today, in today's world, we use phone, mobiles, computer, laptops, all this to send messages, right? Courier, all this. But before previous time, before few years later, before, there were no mobile phones, there were no smartphones, no laptop computer. Okay, means in every home we didn't find, there were no any like computer, but pigeon was there to be used as a messenger, passing the letters. Okay, so the answer is pigeon. So the next one, which bird can fully turn its head round and look behind? Again, it's owl. Number seven, which is the fastest flying bird? Falcon. Number ninth, which animal is associated with the zodiac sign Pisces? It's fish. Okay, number nine, which was the animal sent into space for the first time? Dog is the animal that was sent into space for the first time. Okay, the answer will be dog. Number last, which animal is called the ship of the desert? It's camel. Okay, students, you will get all this content and this video, all this content and exercise in PDF format, that is in our school website, www.bsnes.in. You can collect it from there and you can note down the answers. Okay, so everyone read this, go thoroughly. Okay, so let's meet up in the next video. Till then, thank you. Bye bye.